Hey everyone, so today I am doing the first impression I promised on the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Water Foundation, SPF 15. My shade is in Light Sand. I bought it while I was in Vegas from Sephora. I'll link down below my Las Vegas massive, massive shopping haul if you want to go watch it if you haven't seen it yet. It was pretty impressive. I had 3 bags full of Sephora makeup. Not sure if that's impressive or embarrassing. But anyway, I'm doing this first impression today. So the shade Light Sand, I think, was going to match me when I had less fake tan on, which is me today. I've only got like a thin layer of like a buildable moisturizer fake tan product. So it should hopefully kind of match me. They didn't have a shade that would match me with lots of fake tan on, like I normally, you know, I normally wear a lot of fake tan. So anyway, we're just gonna get started with this. I'm just gonna pull it up on the Sephora website and give you a little bit of information about the product so we know what to expect. So it is $39 US. Deliver the ultimate in hydration boosting coverage with Tarte's 12-hour water foundation. Is it supposed to last 12 hours? The concentrated full coverage fluid formula features 20% water to quench dry skin as it covers and masks any redness, dark spots and uneven skin tone while softening the look of pores and fine lines. So what I am expecting is something that's very hydrating and I'm expecting something that is full coverage. So let's give it a go. As always, I am going to prime one half of my face so we can see if there's any difference with the application and the longevity and everything and the look of it, of course. So I'm going to use the Too Faced Hangover Silicone Free Replenishing Face Primer with coconut water. This is actually very similar to the Marc Jacobs coconut primer. I used it the other day for the first time and it feels almost identical. So I'm just going to use this on, we'll just do this side of my face. So it says to shake it up first. It sounds very liquidy. So it's like in a dropper, like the Cover FX custom cover drops. It's not as liquidy as I expected, but it is quite runny, if you can see this. I have absolutely no idea how much to use. I'm just gonna put some directly on my hand and then apply it to my face that way. So that was like one pump. I think this is gonna match, so I'm just gonna do a little dab everywhere. Ooh, I almost got it on my top. I'm gonna try it with a round face brush. This is by EXO Beauty. We'll try the unprimed side first. Can you hear that? It's my chair. It's very easy to blend. Really nice coverage. At the moment, I'd say it's more of a medium. It feels so nice. Like it feels really lightweight. It feels very thin. It doesn't feel heavy. Like if I talked about the Tarte, what's the other one? This one here, the Amazonian Clay. This is much thicker and creamier. This is much more watery, which I actually prefer. I just feel like it feels nicer on the skin. It doesn't bother me as much because sometimes when I wear a really thick foundation, as much as I love the way it looks, it does feel a little bit intense, you know, by the end of the day, you just want to wash it off. This one here, straight away first impression, it feels very nice. So yeah, it has no issues whatsoever blending out on the unprimed side. Same thing on the prime side, it blends out really nice and easily. This brush works great. Color matches me almost perfectly, which is super good. That's what I like to see. Honestly, I am happy with how that looks. Like, that coverage is so beautiful. It looks medium to full coverage. You can still see a little bit of my redness, a little bit of like freckling. You can kind of see a little bit of blemish areas down here, but it still looks flawless. It doesn't look crazy or anything, but I will just add a tiny bit more so we can see if it's buildable. I've got a little bit left on my hand here. If I compared it to the Marc Jacobs Remarkable foundation, it's definitely a little bit thicker, I think. Not by much though, and I feel like the Marc Jacobs one is a lot silkier when you blend it out. This one's a little bit more creamy. I feel like this one's easier to blend out though. With Marc Jacobs, as I say, I always have to really buff it into my skin to make sure that it doesn't look heavy or patchy, whereas this one doesn't look patchy and I'm not blending it as much. I do see some people saying that Marc Jacobs looks really patchy on them, and if it's patchy, you just need to really like get in there, put in some elbow grease, buff it in, and at first you'll feel like you're just rubbing it off, but really once your skin settles, it just, yeah, it looks incredible. That's how I apply it. So far there's absolutely no difference with the primed and unprimed side. It looks really good on both sides from where I'm sitting, but I'm just gonna look up close quickly. This actually looks beautiful. The finish is quite natural. It's got a slight kind of glow to it. It's not too glowy, it's not too matte. It's kind of in the middle. It's like a demi matte finish on me. It feels like it sets really well. It does transfer a little bit, but it doesn't feel sticky at all. So I would still obviously set it with powder. I always set my foundation with powder no matter what. But it looks incredible. It makes my skin look so fresh and so flawless. I'll do a really super close up. So as you can see, it doesn't really accentuate any of my pores or anything. It just kind of glides over top of them. Over my uneven skin texture, it doesn't really emphasize it at all. It looks really nice and smooth. I actually have a lot of dry skin on my nose at the moment, and it hasn't really picked up on it too much. Maybe a little bit right on this nostril, but it's not bad. I really, really like how it looks close up. I haven't really put any under my eyes, by the way, because I'm going to use concealer there. But yeah, that's how it's looking. We will do a quick flash test now. Honestly, even though it has SPF 15, it doesn't really flash back that badly at all. I'll let you guys be the judge of that. So far, so good. I'm gonna go do the rest of my makeup. I'm gonna put on concealer and powder. I don't even think I need to put any extra concealer on my breakout area. It looks really nice. I think I'm just gonna do a little bit of concealer under my eyes and on my eyelids, and then powder as normal. The time is currently 10 to 11 in the morning, so we'll just say 11 a.m. I'll talk to you guys soon. Hey everyone, quick update. It's now 1 p.m. so it's been on for 2 hours. I did just do a Kylie lip kit try on swatch video. If it's already up, I'll link it down below. So I did wipe off lots and lots of my makeup just around my mouth, just here. So I did reapply that, and it reapplied great. It didn't go cakey or anything like that. And I thought I would do a little update quickly now. I'm about to go out for lunch, so I thought I would just get this little update in now. And then of course I'll come back later. So initial update, it looks incredible. I'm so impressed so far. Like, it looks great. My skin looks so flawless and so pretty and smooth. It just looks healthy and smooth and full coverage, and I love it. This is definitely going to become a regular in my routine. It has not faded, it hasn't creased, it hasn't caked up anywhere, it hasn't gone weird on any dry areas of my face. It feels great. It doesn't even feel like I'm wearing any foundation. It feels so nice. I can definitely see why they say hydrating. Like, it doesn't necessarily feel like I've got moisturizer on my face or anything, but it just doesn't feel like anything. It doesn't feel powdery. Even though I put powder on top of my face today, it doesn't feel powdery. It just feels nice, weightless. By the way, of course, I didn't use any setting sprays or anything like that either today. I never do use setting sprays when I'm doing first impressions, just concealer, powder. But yeah, that's my update. It looks great. It hasn't sunk into any pores or anything like that. I am so happy so far. So I'm gonna come back in a few more hours and we will see how it looks after a more decent amount of time. Cause you know, 2 hours, you would kind of hope that it would look good for 2 hours. So we should see. Hey everyone, so the time is now 5:30. So did I begin this at 11? I always forget, I need to write it down next time. I started at 11, it's now been on for 6.5 hours. And I'm honestly quite happy. It still doesn't feel heavy, it doesn't feel cakey, and it doesn't look cakey either. If I look a little bit more closely, the only way it's changed whatsoever is around my nostrils. It has started to melt a little bit. I'll show you a close-up in 1 second. It hasn't even faded like at all on my skin here. I feel like the dryness, like the little bumps where my pimples are on my skin, is a little bit more obvious, but I'm actually thinking it's probably just the lighting because I didn't notice it in the car half an hour ago when there was actually a little bit of sunlight left. It gets so dark so early now. But yeah, I'm just amazed that it hasn't faded, which is my normal problem. It hasn't gone cakey, it hasn't gone oily, it just looks amazing still. So for 6.5 hours wear, it's freaking awesome. It's like I've worn off a little chunk right here. Where it's worn off around my mouth, that's because I changed my lipstick color earlier, so I wiped it off with a makeup wipe. So that's nothing to do with the foundation. All that's really changed is just in here. It looks a little bit melty. Yeah, the rest of my skin looks really good so far. It hasn't sunk into pores or anything like that. I'm really happy. It looks kind of weird in this lighting, like up close, but honestly, like, I am in love right now. So I'll come back in a few more hours before bed and we'll see how it's looking then. I am ready for bed. My makeup still looks so good. At least my base does. I'm really happy with this foundation. It still has not faded. Almost every single foundation fades on me. It's 10 to 10 p.m. so it's been on for over 10 hours. Yeah, usually by now I would have at least some kind of fading happening, but nothing has faded. It's melted the tiniest amount more just around my nose, but barely any. It still hasn't clung any more onto any of those dry areas. As I said earlier, I think it's just the lighting that accentuates it, because it doesn't actually look like chunky, it doesn't look flaky or anything. It just I don't know, I can just see the mirror, but it's probably the lighting.
Haven't gone oily at all. It sunk slightly into this expression line just by my nose from like smiling, like my cheek line, but only very slightly. The biggest issue all day I've had is just melting around the nostrils, which always happens to me as well. It's such a pain. But at the end of the day, if that's the worst, like holy crap, I really, really like this foundation. So I am happy. I'm really happy. My skin type is normal to dehydrated. It's quite dehydrated at the moment because the weather is very cold. I found it quite hydrating. I found it really comfortable to wear. It's easy to apply. Just works well. So yeah, I'm happy. I like it. I will definitely be using that a little bit more often in my videos, so keep an eye out for it. If you have tried it out, let me know what your thoughts were down below. Leave a comment. Let everyone know what your skin type is and yeah, how you found it, if you love it, if you hate it. I always like to get lots of reviews floating around just so that, you know, it's more helpful for people looking to purchase a product. Because even though I love this foundation, you may hate it depending on your skin type or your needs or your wants or whatever. So as always, make sure you search reviews before you drop all your cash, just in case. I don't want you guys to make terrible purchases. If you have similar tastes to me and you have a similar skin type to me, you must try this. So yeah, I'm really happy. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and I'll talk to you guys in my next one. Bye.
Hey guys, if you want to watch some more of my videos, the video on the left is a chit chat get ready with me for this fun summer makeup. You can click the screen or the link will be down below. And then the video on the right is a get ready with me hair, makeup, and outfit. There we go. I almost forgot what I was meant to say. Thanks for watching. See ya.